Good morning. Blessed Easter to all. Welcome to St. Helen, and thank you for celebrating Easter liturgy with us.
Thank you. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The sequence will be sung in Latin. You can follow along on page 145 and 146.
Victime Paschali Lages, Imole Christi Ani, Agnus Redemit Obes, Christus in Ocet Patri, Precocini Api, Peccatores. Mors et vita duello, Complicere mirando, Dux vite mortus, Regna vivus. Ignobis Maria, Qui vidi spinia, Sepulchrum Christi viventis, et gloria fidi resurgentis. Angelicos estes, sudarium et vestes. Surrexi Christus pes mea, precedet suos in Galilea. Scimus Christum surrexi se, ad mortuis vere, sud nobis victores, miserere.
Do you believe in life after boss asked one of his new employees? Yes, sir, the new employee replied. The boss said, well, after you left early yesterday to go to your grandmother's funeral, she stopped in the office to see you. Easter is a happy time for Christians, for it tells us that there is life after death. It tells us that there is hope no matter how desperate life seems to get. For example, for Jesus' followers, it was a whole different story. Easter Sunday was a sad and dark day. Jesus' followers were expecting Jesus would gather the Jews together and stage a revolution against the all-powerful Roman Empire. They expected the Jews would miraculously defeat the Romans, and Jesus would reign over God's people, and God's people would be free. All their hopes for a better world had been crushed when Jesus was arrested and crucified. When the sun rose on Easter morning, there was nothing but mourning and sadness. To add to their misery that Sunday, things continued to get worse. Some women came to the tomb early and found that the tomb had been opened and the body of Jesus was nowhere to be found. Two of the apostles checked out the situation and discovered it was indeed true that Jesus' body, battered and broken as it was gone. But the cloth that he was buried in was still there. Wasn't a Roman guard posted there to prevent anyone from taking Jesus' body? For Jesus' followers, it was a double loss. They lost him when he was put to death, and now his body had been lost. The fact that people came to the apostles with stories that they had seen Jesus didn't face them, they knew that Jesus was really dead. The soldier's spear thrust him into his heart showed that. They didn't know what to do. Indeed, the first Easter was not a happy one, at least not until Jesus appeared to all his disciples on Easter Sunday night. They couldn't believe what they were seeing. It was a lie. It wasn't just his spirit. He gave them his real body. He just appeared. He was not just alive, like some zombie in the movies, but his body was glorified. This means that Jesus looked like he did when he was transfigured on Mount Tabor. He showed them his hands and his feet and his sides so that they could be sure it was really Jesus. He had to eliminate any doubts about his resurrection because he was going to send them out to proclaim to the world that he had indeed risen. His followers who didn't get to see him would have to believe the word of the apostles. It is something that's not hard to believe, because preaching about Jesus cost most of the apostles their lives. The apostles didn't go out and make a lot of money preaching things they made up that they were not true. Instead, they preached what they saw and witnessed. They had nothing to gain for their efforts. And that's where the word martyr comes from, the Greek word that means witness. So if you have a happy Easter, consider why you are happy. We're not happy because Jesus' first followers were miserable, for they too would be happy. We're happy because Jesus overcame the power of dread, death. And we all know death will get us someday. peace and eternal happiness. Jesus died so we live like him forever. My brothers and sisters, let us ask the Lord our God blessing. Dear friends, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may rise with him to a new life. Now that we have completed our Lenten observance, let us renew the promises we made in baptism when we rejected Satan and his works and promised to serve God faithfully in his holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children?
I do.
Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin?
I do.
Do you reject Satan, the father of sin and the prince of darkness?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
God, the all-powerful Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, has given us a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and forgiven all our sins. May he also keep us faithful to our Lord Jesus Christ forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord is risen, heaven and earth rejoice in the reconciliation of God with all creation. Filled with Easter joy, we bring to God our needs for the church and for the world. For the community that is called the church, we are an Easter people, and we ask God's blessing on the church. May our witness to the resurrection be a source of joy and hope in a world of despair and pain. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. May you say, God, in the
So with confidence we pray from our hearts for the intentions of all here, for those most in need of our prayers, and for all our personal intentions in the depths of our hearts unspoken. For these we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Give therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all those who hold him to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Celebrating that most sacred day of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Chrysogonus, Lawrence, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we made to you also for those to whom you have been pleased to give the birth of water and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness of all their sins. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock that you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took his precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said a blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." This spotless victim, these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as one who will please to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of light, happiness, and peace. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not laying our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord. Through whom you continue to make these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with light, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Easter, on behalf of Father Mishler also, that the risen Lord who accompanies his church, for he is risen, he guides and accompanies us on our journey to the heavenly kingdom and eternal life. May he be very present to you, companion to you on your life journey, sustaining you in hard times. We pray especially that the risen Lord sustain those who are on the front lines during this pandemic that is threatening our world, that the Lord Jesus will see them through, uphold them, and with his providential hand, keep them safe and healthy to all of you also. A blessing and happy Easter. Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that, renewed by the paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, and the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Let the power.